The president will take to the airwaves to try to convince Americans that it was the right decision for the U.S. to be part of the Allied fight in Libya, a third battlefront for the United States, with a lot of military force on the line and costing possibly billions. Our Jake Tapper is standing by in the hall where the president is about to arrive at the National Defense University in Washington. Jake, do you have the headline on what he's going to say?
Good evening, Diane. Well, President Obama tonight, according to White House sources, is going to try to bring the American people into his decision-making process, this quick decision that he made, explaining why the U.S. moved so quickly to stop a potential massacre of Libyan civilians, and also why the U.S. worked the way it did to work internationally so as to prevent getting bogged down in yet another war.
After 10 days of the coalition pounding Gaddafi's forces, President Obama will tonight take his case to the American people. Here's what he said over the weekend.
When someone like Gaddafi threatens a bloodbath that could destabilize an entire region, and when the international community is prepared to come together to save many thousands of lives, then it's in our national interest to act.
The president will underline that the U.S. will not be sending in ground troops and that NATO, not the U.S., has assumed command and control responsibilities. But it's unclear if the president will tackle the many difficult questions, such as how long will U.S. participation in this operation continue?
Do you think we'll be gone by the end of the year? Will the mission be over by the end of the year?
I don't think anybody knows the answer to that.
How much will this end up costing America? Officials say the first week's offensive alone cost roughly $600 million, including launching 192 U.S. Tomahawks at $1.4 million each. And what's the end game for the U.S.? Removing Gaddafi from power is not a goal of the military campaign, though it's what the U.S. wants. Theoretically, the coalition could successfully maintain a no-fly zone, and its air assault could stop Gaddafi's forces from attacking civilians, with Gaddafi remaining in power.
I can't, sitting here today, predict to you exactly how it's going to play out.
And Diane, another significant question is, what kind of precedent does this set? Will the U.S. get involved every time a dictator starts slaughtering his own people, as is happening at several other hotspots throughout the world? And if the U.S. will not do that, why not? These are some of the questions the American people have on this 10th day of this military campaign.